Hey everyone, I'm JD. Welcome back to my channel. I have three journals to show you this time, all vintage themed, all very similar, all using these Reader's Digest books. So this is tracking my journey. This was the first time that I actually used hardbound books with the cover for my journals, and I absolutely loved it, so it became my favorite method so far of creating journals. And this one I experimented with washi tape on the spine, and I loved how that looked, so I ended up doing that again with lots of my other journals. So yeah, I will do a flip through of these, and I've got a few pockets and tags and tucks in these, not too many, just a small scattering throughout. And I used Tim Holtz Wallflower, I think it's called, that paper. It's so amazing. I love it. It's just gorgeous. And I also used his pocket card collection and some of his ephemera packs to decorate the covers and the pages. And some Project Life cards too. So there's a few different bits and pieces scattered throughout. And these also I have used it's coffee and tea dyed pages. So back when I was just starting again, just trying to track my journey with these videos and record how I progressed. So moving up to the whole book cover journal, and then the tea dye, coffee dyeing pages. So that's what I kind of do from now on. It's more book covers and the vintage look. So yeah, cool to track my journals. This was one of my favorite pictures, and I used this, the big version of this that came in the scrapbook pack, for a cover of one of these journals. And that journal actually was my very first journal to sell. I sold it last year in December. It was my sister-in-law who bought it, and she loved it, and she was my very first customer, so I was so excited. And everyone I've shown, literally every single person I've shown my journals to, has never heard of a junk journal before. So when I show them these, they just love them too. They love them. But when I discovered them, it was like this whole new world that I discovered, and it was just amazing. I fell in love with it straight away, and now I haven't met a single person who I've shown these to who doesn't like them either. They just think they're really cool too. So I just think that it's just such an awesome idea. I absolutely adore journals. I collect them, I love them, I write in them. I already scrapbook and kind of collect ephemera, I just didn't know that's what it was called. But to have a beautiful book itself, like, the book itself is just awesome. And then to add your own things to it, your own writing and your photos and your ephemera, I just think it's the most amazing combination you can create. And I absolutely love it. I cannot rave enough about junk journals. Like, it's just like I found my home. And I know so many of you out there also have found your home too. Like, when I look at the Facebook page and read everyone's comments about how they discovered junk journaling, and yeah, it's just this amazing world that so many of us love. And yeah, I just wanted to introduce junk journaling to the world, because everyone loves it. Even if you're not a writer or a person who documents things, you can just appreciate the book for itself. Like, the book is amazing, handmade, every page interesting. And I especially love the books that have something meaningful about the book itself. So I think that's what I want to progress to, is my style. I do love the vintage look and everything, but what I really want to do is more meaningful books. books, more meaningful pages and things. So I know this is what I want to do for me personally, create some books that where the pages actually mean something to me, that come from my own life. So I've mentioned this before, how I have a folder for each year of my life. And just, it has all different things, report cards, birthday cards, letters from family members, and just notes that I wrote, and some schoolwork, and awards and certificates, and yeah, all different sorts of things. And I want to put it all together in a journal. And I love that I can actually use the things as the pages. I'm not sure if that makes sense, but yeah, it's going to be a massive project, and that's why I've put it off for a long time, but that's what's always in the back of my mind. That's what I'm heading towards. So all of this, I absolutely love doing this. It's for fun, and I love making these, but these are for other people. So the ones that I want to make for me, I want to use all that stuff that I have that is from my own life. And then eventually what I would love to do is kind of make the same things for other people. So I would love to use things from their lives, and papers and cards and letters and all different things from their life, and put those together in a book. And I'm not sure how I'll do that. maybe they can send it electronically or something, and I can print it out and turn it into a book. Or I don't know, it's just my ideas. This is what journaling for me, junk journals for me, is about, is the memory keeping and having the book actually say something about your life. I just love this. Anyway, and not just the things you put in it. I don't know. I'm still trying to work out what I exactly mean and what my vision is with that. But I thought I'd share that with you, and just want to share with you my journey of where I've been with these journals, and where I currently am with my experimenting, and then kind of my plan or dream or vision for where I want to go in the future. So yeah, I'll just keep you updated, and we'll see how it goes. If you want to keep following my journey and you like my journals, do let me know, and subscribe. I so appreciate all of your wonderful comments and your likes, and it's just really, really cool to be part of this amazing, creative, inspiring community. And everyone's just so lovely and nice and encouraging and supportive, and it's just, yeah, really cool to be part of. I'm so glad I found it. And we can create together and inspire each other and make these beautiful journals. So yeah, thank you again so much for watching, and I will see you again in the next video.